Well, today we're going to check out the new version of the much-loved and highly regarded XTOOL D7. This is the new XTOOL D7S. And pretty much the same case like it always had, only it's a different color. It's black this time. Somewhat of a new logo. And let's open it up and check it out. Okay, so inside you've got a packing list and a quick start guide. We've got some specs, which I will go over here in a few minutes. We've got the data cable itself. We've got several styles. Let me put this down here so you can see it. Several styles of power cords, depending on which part of the world you're located in. And you can use either one of these three cords along with this charging brick. And then you've also got a USB-A to USB-A USB cord. Kind of an odd configuration, but nonetheless, they sent that with. And then, of course, got the scan tool itself. On the top, there's a USB-A port with a rubber cover over the top. You've got your data port for the data cord. You've got your electrical connection for charging and a power button. And there's nothing on the other three edges of the tool. And on the back, you've got a camera with a flash. And this D7 now includes a kickstand, which is pretty nice. So the new D7 also comes with a new graphical user interface. It's a brand new look and feel, a brand new layout for the XTOOL scan tools now. And of course you've got your diagnostic tab, which includes auto scan, special functions, report, one touch updates. You've got more. And then down here is your remote control where somebody from XTOOL could remote into your tablet, your scan tool, and give you assistance with a problem you may be having. Now, somebody in one of my recent comments posted that not only can someone from XTOOL remote into this tablet, but you could give permission to somebody, another person, to remote into this. So another friend or a fellow mechanic or somebody else could help you out remote into that from their computer. So that would be kind of cool. And then you've got your settings tab. Now, that's the settings tab for the scan tool software, not for the Android tablet software. And then this shortcut right here is just a shortcut to the XTOOL website. And if we click more, you've got your profile here, which is your personal account, if you will, on the XTOOL website. I'm not going to click that because that just shows my personal information. Then you've got your VCI management. VCI is, of course, the connection, your data connection to the vehicle. You've got your endoscope app, and then of course you've got a PDF file for the user's manual for this particular tablet. Now, one thing I wanted to mention while I'm showing you the endoscope app here, I am able to get pretty much any endoscope, any just generic cheap endoscope will work with this. This particular one was like a $20 endoscope off of Amazon. You plug it in, hit the endoscope app, and it works. However, there is one thing I need to show you with that. Let's go back to the settings here. We'll click the settings, and we have to go down to this right here. It says USB settings. If you click that, it gives you two options here. You have to select this option. You have to select that option in order to get the endoscope to work. They call it data transfer mode or expansion mode. I would probably call it host or client mode, but you get the idea. Make sure it's set here and then plug your endoscope in and it should work just fine. Anyway, while we're in the settings menu here, you can see a few of the other settings. You got language, you got your unit of measurement, the USB setting, sounds and display, and the about. Pretty standard stuff. And those are settings for scan tool software. So we could pull up the bottom menu bar here and click the home screen. Oops. And this would take us to the Android home screen. And then, of course, there's a settings menu down here, which would give you settings for the Android tablet. You can either click here or here to go back to the scan tool app. boom, we're right back into the ScanTool app. Now give me 1 second, I'm going to get this connected to the vehicle, and I'll be right with you. Okay, I've got it connected to the vehicle, but before I go any farther, I just want to put this paper up on the screen here so you can see it a little bit better. This is the new D7S compared to the older D7, and you can read all the different specs there for each one individually. I'm not going to go through it all, but down below on the left, you'll see the main differences between these two, and it starts off with the new D7S has a collapsible kickstand. It has a rear camera with flash. It has a larger battery than the D7. It has double the storage space. And it has the all-new look and feel graphical user interface. So those are the main differences between this and the older one, which I believe is a pretty good improvement over the older DS, considering the older DS was pretty good already to begin with. And just to start off with, we're sitting in a 2022 Kia, and this is one of those newer makes and models of vehicles that does require a cloud connection. The scan tool does require internet connection to the cloud in order for some or most of the features and functions on the vehicle to work. I should be able to pull codes and whatnot without a cloud connection, but this particular vehicle, not the scan tool, any scan tool that plugs into this car requires a cloud connection via the internet. So this is not how any of the cars used to be back in the old days, but this newer stuff is this way. But anyway, we'll go into auto scan. We're probably not going to spend too much time going over how this scan tool works, because it works pretty much like any other XTOOL scan tool, and there's been dozens and dozens and dozens of videos about how these scan tools work, you know, already made on the internet. I myself have already made multiple videos about how they work, but I'm going to show you a few of the differences. Communication being established, that's with the cloud. Checking the license, there we go. So if you can see that there, I'll go into the USA. That's my vehicle. Connected to the network. We'll do auto scan. Okay, it's finished up. I've got one trouble code here in the engine controller, and it's the PO47100. It's the exhaust pressure sensor A circuit range performance. We're going to let the dealer take care of that. But otherwise, everything else here is just fine. And we'll go to system selection. Here's all the different modules within this vehicle. I want to go into the engine control module because one of the things I want to show you is the live data capabilities in the graphing. So let's get into the engine controller here, and we'll pick a few data PIDs to look at in live data. Again, everything that this vehicle is doing now is doing it scan tool connected to the vehicle, and then it's also talking to the cloud at the same time. It's really unnecessary, but we'll select live data, and give me 1 second here. Okay, so here's all the data PIDs that I've picked. AC pressure, some O2 sensors, coolant temperature sensor, accelerator pedal, engine speed, etc. If I just click graph right now, it will graph all of these. It shrinks them all down into smaller graphs, and it tries to put it, and it get four of them on the screen at once, which is pretty nice. We can go back. Let's see here. If I go back and I can graph each, like say I wanted to graph just the accelerator pedal, it will graph that in the full screen. And here I can zoom in and zoom out, refresh, start over. So the graphing is pretty good. It's nice that you can get more than one or two graphs on the screen at once. So that's what I wanted to show you. You've got your actuation tests on this particular car. This is the type of stuff that needs the cloud for it to work correctly, along with most other things. Right now it's communicating with the cloud to see what it will let me do. I hate it, but that's just the way things are going nowadays. So you can see all the different, this is just all the bidirectional controls and actuation test type stuff that can be done in the engine control module. Each module will have its own list of actuation controls and special functions. So we're going to exit this. Now, one thing I wanted to mention, if you looked at that list that I put up earlier, see where on the very top underneath the specs, it'll say 36 plus services with some asterisks next to it. And if you go down the bottom, you can see where my asterisks, I have that down as kind of some marketing BS. And the reason why I say that is, and this is not a dig at XTOOL, it's pretty much every scan tool manufacturer out there right now. They all have these special functions. And I've gone over this before, so if you've heard me say this in past videos, please forgive me, but there are some people that haven't heard this yet, so I want to cover it one more time. These special functions here, this is a list of things that this scan tool can do. It doesn't mean this scan tool can do all of this stuff on every vehicle you plug into. You know, for example, and I've used these examples before, when I used to do these videos in my old GMC pickup, it was a gasoline-powered GMC pickup. And like right here, here's a DPF. I can't force a gasoline pickup truck to regenerate its diesel particulate filter. You know, here's another one, electronic parking brake. That old gasoline pickup truck had hydraulic drum brakes. What's that going to do? That's nothing. So, you know, take a vehicle that doesn't have a steering angle sensor. You know, it's on here somewhere, the SAS, right here, SAS. What good is that going to do on a vehicle that doesn't have a steering angle sensor? You know, there's lots of things on here. And so the reason why I'm bringing this up is because I hear people say in comments under various videos, well, yeah, but half the stuff on that scan tool doesn't work. Well, it would work if you were plugged into a vehicle that could use all the functions. You know, you can't expect everything to work on a vehicle that don't have the hardware to support it. And another example, we're going to use this, let's see here, where is it? We'll use this tire upgrade as one last example. I have tried using this, you know, going into this special function menu on previous scan tools, going down, clicking tire upgrade on vehicles that I know I can change the tire size, and it doesn't work. But if I go into the diagnosis menu, go into the control unit, go into the ABS module, and then within the ABS module, there is special functions where I can change the tire size. And I was able to change the tire size just fine. So 99 times out of 100, when I'm using a scan tool, I pretend this menu function right here doesn't even exist. Does me no good. Every special function that you need on any given car that you're plugged into at any given time will be listed in the control unit in any given module. Now, you may have to look, like for programming keys, you'll have to go into here and find the immobilizer unit or maybe the body control module. Every vehicle could be different. You have to maybe search and look for the function. But when you find it in here, these are functions that are specific to the vehicle you're plugged into. These are functions that the scan tool is capable of, but they're just shortcuts to, who knows, it may or may not even work. But if you go in through here, you're going to have a much better time getting functions to work correctly. I just wanted to cover that. That is not specific to the D7S. That's scan tools in general. That's what I have found anyway in my own personal experience. Your mileage may vary. But anyway, the new D7S, excellent scan tool. It's been an excellent scan tool. The previous D7 was awesome. It even got awesomer when the big update came out about a year or so ago, just over a year ago, when it gave it full bidirectional control. Previously, the D7 was missing a few things. But they upgraded it. It's got full bidirectional control. This scan tool can pretty much do anything you would ever need a scan tool to do, unless you're into, like, you know, advanced driving assistance, you know, ADAS features and stuff like that. For your average guy working on your average vehicle, doing average repairs, this does 99.9% of everything. And you really can't go wrong. It's an excellent scan tool. So, but that's all I have for now. Please be sure to like, share, and subscribe for more. Thanks for watching.